for both of you at this stage in the journey, what does the story and these characters now mean to both of you?
Oh, just a huge amount. I mean, it's something that Heidi and I have been working on solidly for over a decade, so it's part and parcel of our lives, really, isn't it?
I can't imagine life now without Call the Midwife. As Pippa says, it's not only more than a decade. I think it's about 15 years since we first discussed it. So it has been part of our lives. We've grown old with it, and the characters have grown along with us, I think.
Yeah, not they that
never,
old.
Obviously. No, they never seem to age. We age a bit.
What are you still most excited about exploring with these characters? And is there territory we delve into in these new episodes that you think we maybe haven't seen before in the long and glorious run of the show thus far?
I think one of the skills of what Heidi does as a screenwriter is that she every year finds new fascinating pieces of social history and medical history that we haven't touched on before. And because we only ever go forwards a year at a time, we're never in danger of, you know, running out of material or getting too far ahead of ourselves. So each year there's something new and fascinating to cover. Don't you think?
Yes, I think so. I mean, every year I sit down after the Christmas special has gone out with a glass of Baileys and I think, where am I going to take this world in 1967 or 1968, which is where series 12 is set. And my first thing, I usually go through newspaper archives and medical archives side by side, seeing how the social conditions of the day kept pace with medical developments. And there's always some sort of crossover. It's fascinating.
Of course, the incomparably beautiful Helen behind you having a photo taken there. How important was it for you and the rest of the family behind the show that she was able to come back again in season 12 and obviously with the special?
I don't think it ever occurred to us that she wouldn't come back, because Helen's very loyal to us and we're very loyal to Helen. So it was just a case of waiting for her to, you know, have her time at home with her baby and then come back and join us. So it wasn't difficult, really, was it? And she does have a very handy godmother in Portofino to whom she flees.
Yes.
This time
story
to
terms.
Yeah. This time to get over her addiction to capes.
Do you have a final word to fans of the series who love and support it and can't wait for it to continue for hopefully many years to come?
Oh, well, just thank you for watching us and supporting us for all this time, and keep watching.
Yeah, absolutely, keep watching. We aren't done yet.
It's amazing to have you here for us today at the BFI. Helen, starting with you, can you talk a little bit about how it feels to be coming back to the character and what it is about this family that makes you want to keep being a part of it after all these years?
It's really lovely to be back. Yeah, because obviously I had half the series off last year to have a baby. So it's nice to be back, and it's nice to be coming back post COVID restrictions on set as well, because we were all saying it's nice to be close again and actually just be able to touch in scenes and do all the normal stuff that we're supposed to do. And, you know, us three have been through it for the last 12 years. So it's a pretty long relationship with the show and with characters as well. So it's lovely to come back. Yeah. But it's still challenging, which is why it keeps us interested.
What you think is the magic of the show, why people love it so much, it means so much to them?
I think it speaks to the better side of themselves. I think that the compassion and the kindness there is not a rare or fantasy thing. It's real, it speaks to them. Sometimes people say, how do you manage to make people cry? And I think the answer is, no, we don't make people cry. People cry. And why do people cry? Because something we're doing makes them think of kindness. It makes them think of people being nice to each other, and that makes them cry, because people are basically decent inside. I think that's the magic of it. And we are more modest about that than people might think. There's no clever puppetry going on. We're showing people what happens when a society can care for itself as much as it can. When people have that attitude to care for themselves, that's a very broad thing. It's not alien. It shouldn't be alien. And people respond to that.
As we push on to season 12 and beyond, what are you and the rest of the cast most excited about getting to explore that we perhaps haven't seen in all the amazing seasons of the past?
Oh my goodness, what guys have just left me? What can I talk about season 12? I don't know what I'm allowed to say. Well, I mean, the beauty of the show, I mean, you know, we've all been in it from the beginning, but the beauty is that characters can come and go. I don't know if I'm going to say the wrong thing.
Johnny Depp relationship. Talk about Johnny Depp.
So inappropriate. There's loads going on. There's characters returning from past series, which would be really nice and refreshing to see how they're getting on all these years later.
You genuinely know more than me. See, you found out because we've done Christmas and we've just read one.
No, babe, I'm just blagging.
Oh!
We don't. don't know because we haven't seen the scripts. It's the truth.
Basically. But, hey, can we talk about the fact that we have a slightly bigger set? Our world has expanded. So Nanata's house, and you normally see this at forecourt with the railway bridge and everything. We've got, there's more streets, there's new sets. So it's quite nice when it's sort of re-energized like that, you know, and it does feel super exciting. And we do have really, really swish trailers this year. So everybody's in a very, very good mood.